Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of our Let's Play. I need another miscellaneous chest. I don't even know why netherrack's over here. Blocks go over here, and this is like items. But I have a misc chest here, and same as here, but they're always getting filled up. So we need another. So we get rid of these metal rods. And then these, I suppose. Yes, we're still playing with candles. Does that make it look better? You got tall candles and short candles. Actually, yeah. And why not throw some on the birthday cakes? Hey, someone said you can light them with a sword. Okay, well, maybe not when it's on a cake. Oh, wait, do you have to right-click it? Oh! Wait. How long has this been in the game? Are you telling me? All this time? Holy smokes. This is the ultimate test. I'm gonna lose my mind if this works. Okay. Okay, it doesn't work for everything. I have no idea why, but I just kinda wanna walk around in the house for once. Well, we're going to do other things, but I just have this urge to kind of fix things up. Nothing really needs to be fixed up, but random stuff like this stuff laying here, I don't really like it because it's a waste of space in a very important room that needs to house certain things. Like, I want this in here somewhere, but right here doesn't seem good enough. If that makes sense. What am I using this for right here? And I have a deep slate diamond ore. I want to find a place to put an anvil and this on top to kind of display it in my house. Do we plan on getting another glowing one? Because this would be a perfect, well, it's not centered. I'm gonna figure some stuff out. You know what I really look forward to? Like, really look forward to? That is, I like doing this with, this isn't what I really look forward to, but if you have random barrels sitting throughout your house, put like random stuff like this in it, because sometimes when you're looking through it, these little items might come in handy, and it's also just a filler. But I really look forward to getting concrete or terracotta slabs and stairs. I got a feeling we'll get concrete first. No, if they add either or, they're gonna add them to both. But I would love to put upside down stairs like in these areas. Plus, it would make our house look a whole lot better having those blocks available. Daha! Oh, I remembered something finally. That's what I was going to do today. I want to go throughout my world and try to eliminate as many torches as possible because I saw a comment last episode that said I should try using the moss carpet block, which is a great idea, to go around and place hidden lighting, which I don't know why I've never thought of that because moss carpet block looks so much like grass, you won't even really notice. And then I noticed in here, look, I have four lanterns right here and four of these up here. And why do I have these ugly torches here? I mean, those have been there since day one, but I think I've just been scared if I got rid of them, I would have a few dark spots. Like right here, this is a dark spot. I don't really know how to cover that though. I put this lantern here a while ago, so maybe I shouldn't. See, it kind of makes it darker right there. What about this one? Ooh, that makes it too dark. Lighting is tricky. But then again, I could get rid of that and then put four candles there. I even have a torch way up there. That's ugly. Okay, don't really know what I changed in here, but I did some stuff. I always like using this table as like the new features table or cool things, I guess. Do you guys have a room like that in your base where you just, your favorite room where you just put stuff in and you like being there? This is mine. Okay, so now I need to go around and, well, let's spot our first torch. Where is he? On my house. Okay, those don't count. Hey, I did a good job. See, like, what is this guy doing here? That can be easily covered. Not really. How do I do this? Okay, I need it to be nighttime. Dang it. We shall wait for night. Alright. So, You gotta go, buddy. So, for instance, we can put that there and just throw that on top. Well, it's gonna be so much better than all these torches laying about. There's a hidden crafting table there. That can be replaced with a lantern. Man, I'm doing the best I can. I didn't realize how many torches I had littered all throughout my world. It's hard to go in daytime, and I only covered this area of my house. And I still see torches everywhere. Well, I have some on posts. Oh, my lord. And I'm already almost out of these materials. That's how much I've placed. Well, I kind of did the front yard, too. But as you can see, a lot less... Oh, what the? There's one right there. Go right there. Yeah. I've been trying. It's looking a little better, though. How did I miss this one? I'm just walking... Okay, this is like a perfect spot, too, because I already have moss here. Is that another one? No. Hey, gosh darn it. My cow's gone. I used to have a cow. Is the lead still here? No. That's odd. Usually the lead stays there if they despawn, so he must have got off somehow. I always had a cow here for milk. You know what? I just need to end up making a proper cow farm, because I still don't have one. Oh my god, look at all these torches. Oh god. I'm already out of glowstone. This thing is still here. Back when we started messing around with banners for the first time, like, a few of them glitched out and I placed this one, and I can't even break it. Alright, so over time, when... Was it update aquatic? Oh no, it was a recent update when Exolotls came. Or as the British people call it, axolotl. I don't know which is the proper way to say it, but Exolotl sounds way easier to say and it sounds like the proper way, but axolotl sounds strange. I'm just gonna call it Exolotl. So yeah, we have a few in here. I'm just gonna take one. I thought I had more. Wait, is my fish still in here? Okay, Sammy the Salmon used to be in here, but, oh, okay, yeah, I restocked it with one of these. Is this guy going to kill it, I wonder? I don't know. Well, yeah, there he goes. Sorry, Salmon, I want an Exolotl in here. Hey, buddy. You cutie. Okay, stay in there. I can't breathe. Yay. I don't know why I didn't do that sooner. Oh, yeah, and there's going to be a lot of fish down there, so he's probably going to constantly try to get down there. You know, these are the most unique creatures I've ever heard of because they can literally regenerate bone and tissue and all that. If one of their limbs gets chopped off, they'll grow a whole new limb. Bone, nerves, major arteries, it all just regenerates. And scientists have been studying these creatures forever and even finding ways to use their cells as something to treat humans. I don't know how that would work, but it's just unique to think about an animal out there that has like the same properties as Wolverine or like Deadpool. Over in the graveyard, you know what we're gonna build? Well, it's probably the title of this video. We're gonna make some crypts under the graveyard. No other better place to do it. And maybe we can create some sort of tunneling system connected to our sewer or something like that. I really want this whole underground system going all throughout my world. I even want my lab to have an underground system. I think this will be a great spot to just make some creepy caverns under, well, the graveyard here. Now, I thought about making a building like this somewhere to enter into the crypts, which would make sense, but I don't know why I'm imagining it right here. Like, I want a line of trap doors here that you can open up, and you can walk down this creepy hallway that goes down. So I'm going to try to build this and see how it turns out. Okay, I've been trying to figure out what blocks I wanted to use for this. This is actually a difficult process. I decided to go with all the dark blocks. Ignore this right now. This looks odd. There's no good dark trapdoors in this game, I've noticed. And I've also tried these ones, the crimson and the warped. They look too out of place compared with stone. I wish we had a nice dark colored, something that would go with stone. This is the only one that goes good with stone, but doesn't really go that well here. So this is gonna be the start of the crypt. It's gonna go down. I'm using all these dark colors. This is actually basalt, and the bottom part of it actually goes really well with cobbled deep slate. Makes it look almost like the cracked variant, or just like a different, just a tiny bit texture change. Anyway, it goes really well with it. So this is the kind of color pattern I'm gonna go with here. And right in here is just gonna be somewhat of a small room. This will be about the size, just lined with different types of old graves. I don't know necessarily who's going to be buried in here, but we also have this deep hole here, and I'm actually going to use this as like a little part that looks like a cave-in and part of the crypt. I want this place to be very old. and you kind of want to avoid it as you walk in. So I'm going to try to transform this place, see what I can do. Okay, got the crypt built. Not the design on the inside though, but like the outer shell. I think it looks just fine. I'm going to leave this hole here. Like I said, I want it to remain dangerous. I haven't even been down there, so one day if I do fall, I'll find out. And I realize that hole goes all the way up there too, so it could look like some boulder smashed through or something. So I do want it to be bigger than this. It's going to be a bunch of diverging hallways all the way throughout. I'll probably start one like right here going that way and another one going that way. But as of right now, this is just going to be the first crypt room. So we want to get rid of all these torches. I'm going to do some soul lanterns and skulls and little graves and some candles, maybe some dripstone. See how it turns out. Loving the eerie vibe in here. Now this is going to be a place where I won't absolutely care at all if mobs spawn and even creepers blow it up. Because, well, that's worth the creepy look. Okay, so we're going to put full blocks on there, and then I'm going to do this trick again to make it look like maybe the casket was robbed or something. Press some of these two. Don't want to make this thing look perfect. Need some mossy. Can you make cracked stairs? No, I don't think you can. That would be a good idea, though. There we go. Now, I don't want this torch here, but I do want this grave to be slightly lit up, so maybe if I do some candles near it. What's that? Oh, it's a slab. I can't do it. How about that? Ooh, yeah. Man, you can't use anything with slabs. You can't use these on slabs whatsoever. Some right there. Put another one right. Man, that's what I get for using slabs everywhere. All right, it is finished. The only part I hate about it is this right here. I'm going to change this as soon as I can. But like I said, though, far from finished. I want to make a lot of tiny caverns going everywhere. Yeah. I hate it when the candles aren't lit and then they slowly pop on. That's so lame. I don't like that. I almost feel like there's too much going on. Maybe that's too much right there. But I love the dripping sound in here. I just want to throw up some... No. There we go. Some iron armor. Maybe there was a warrior in here. Got a little grave type thing right there as well. And just threw some candles all over the place. In the hallways that we're going to be making, I want them to be very hard to maneuver through and make them very claustrophobic. Not even this size. Most of them I want like one wide. But I also kind of made this one somewhat claustrophobic. I like having candles and chains hanging down. Yeah, this is a good addition for this place. Who do you think this grave should go to? Or, not that we're going to give it to someone, but maybe someone who used to be here. Who should it be? Alright, well that's enough of that. What is that, Mercury? Might be Mars. One of them. Today's comment question of the day comes from Not Dylan. How did you start getting into Minecraft? I believe I've answered this a few times in this Let's Play, but there's always new people. So, if you did not know, I started getting into Minecraft. I think the first YouTuber I watched was UberHacksorNova, and this was like before his Try Mountain Survival, like those very popular series of his, which were so good. Man, those were really good series. But yeah, I remember just, I very vaguely remember just watching a random video of his one day, and it was just Minecraft, and he was playing duo with someone else. I'm like, what is this game? It looks so interesting. And yeah, after that, I think I just really got into it by watching people play it, and then it finally came out for Xbox 360, and that was my first Minecraft experience I ever had, was on the Xbox 360, and then I played that for a long time until they announced Pocket Edition, and then moved on to Pocket Edition. Played that for a little bit. It was very, very basic, just like the early days of Minecraft Java. And, well, we just had to wait for it to update. And then me and my friend found a recording device, and I made my first video. And it was like, I think it wasn't my first video was like called Pocket Edition Village Tour, and it's absolutely horrible. I haven't seen it in a long time because I actually want to make a reaction video to it just to, I don't know, to introduce Facecam to my channel and, well, see how I react. I can barely remember my first video, but I want to watch it so bad, but I've been holding off. And not like my second video is like a mine, was it Mine Builder? No, that was later on. I can't remember that one. But one of the first main Pocket Edition videos was called the 0.2.1 update where we got pigs and bookshelves. Remember that specifically. I made a whole update video on that. But yeah, that was kind of my first experience. So thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you in the next episode. Bye-bye.